Let's talk about Obsidian plugins that will improve your productivity and make your notes more visual. Once you've downloaded the essential plugin list, let's talk about today on how to save you more time, and if you're a visual learner, how to make your notes more visual. Let's get to it. Productivity plugin number one is definitely Dataview. This, in essence, helps you make more complex and customizable searches in your Obsidian and be able to draw out those results for you in a more manageable way. So what do I mean by that? Let's say, you know, doing search in Obsidian is, of course, very easy. Just go to search and, you know, type in, let's say, hashtag Twitter. All of the notes with the Twitter hashtag will show up. Now, that's good, but it's really hard to manage all of these notes together. You can open each one as is, but how do you work with all of the notes that are there if you want to? So instead, what you can do is use a data view to run the query and get the results. So in my writing idea tracker, I have Twitter ideas that need to be visualized, Twitter ideas that are already visualized, newsletter ideas, and the ones that already have been published, and a list of anecdotes. So I'm just starting to pull this writing idea tracker together. And instead of, let's say, use a Kanban board and pull every single note that has this hashtag in it, which is really manual and wastes a lot of time, all I need to do is use Dataview to pull this list together for me. Let me show you what I mean. So all I need is 4 lines of code. And do not fret if you don't know how to code. It's literally copy and paste and it will work. So let me just walk you through it, bear with me. So you activate Dataview, then you write in list, which tells Dataview that I want a list. And I want this list populated from the hashtag Twitter. And I want this list to not include notes that is hashtagged visualized. So what does that mean? That means I have notes in my Obsidian that are hashtagged with Twitter, which means that this is an idea I want to talk about on Twitter. And then when I do talk about them and I usually visualize them on my Twitter, then I come back to the note and I add the image I've drawn into the note and hashtag it visualized. So this way it's kind of like moving the status of the idea from just an idea ready for Twitter to it having been visualized in Twitter. So when I create these lists, I want to have a list of Twitter ideas that I have not yet visualized, as well as a list of the ones I've already done. So I can see from very quickly what my ideas are, which one I should work on, which one I should perhaps build upon. And so in this way, instead of manually trying to find old links and creating a list, this is so much easier. You can find Dataview, of course, same in settings, and then go to community plugins, look for them. Here we go, Dataview. As you can see, a very popular plugin, and you just need to install enable. And even though the description of Dataview here might be quite confusing, and let me know if you want a more detailed video on how Dataview works, but I'll leave the 4 lines of code that helps you pull together a list from hashtags in the description below so you can play with that. And that is Dataview. Going along this line of retrieving notes for you, the next plugin for productivity is Unlinked File. So as the name suggests, this plugin helps you pull together all of the files that are unlinked. These are the orphan ideas that just hang around by themselves alone in your Obsidian, and they get lost in your vault. So being able to resurface them is a great productivity hack, because then you can take ideas you already have and start to make more connections within your notes. We go to settings, community plugin again, search for unlinked. Find unlinked file is the name of the plugin. And you download, you enable, and then you'll be able to find your unlinked files. So how do you find that? Now, if you watch the essential plugin video, you know that if you press Command P or Control P on the PC, you bring out the command palette. And if you type in the keyword, let's say unlinked, you'll see that these are the commands available for unlinked files. So we want to do number one, find unlinked files. So let's click that. And here we go. Here is the unlinked file output. which gives you all of the notes that are unlinked. And looks like I've got quite a few here. Just like in our brain, it's really hard to make use of all the knowledge that we have, all the ideas that we have. But with this plugin, Find Unlinked File, it does the work for us to go through which ideas have not yet been reviewed, have not yet created connections with other notes, other ideas. And you can just go through this list whenever you have time and you want to review your notes in order to make more connections in your Obsidian Vault. Huge time saver. No idea will get lost with this unlinked file output. Productivity plugin number three is paste URL into selection. So that basically means if you have a text, you can add the link directly onto that text. So for example, how it would look like is like this, where the source now is a clickable link to a URL. Now, if we see previously, if you wanted to do this, you have to go square bracket, single square bracket, the text that you want the link to be on, and then you do single brackets for the link that comes after. So a lot of work, you have to memorize all that, but now with paste URL into selection, you just need a hotkey. So if you go to settings, community plugin, you browse for paste URL, you'll see this plugin, you download it, you enable it, and press hotkeys here in order to set up the shortcut that will do this automatically for you. Now let's move on to visual plugins. The first one is Highlightr. I don't know why Obsidian doesn't have this built in, but Highlightr is an awesome plugin. Let me show you. If you search Highlightr, I think it's spelled like this, yes. Highlightr without the E in the tur. Once you install option, you can set hotkeys for different colored highlighters. Right now I only have yellow turned on, but you can set different hotkeys for different colors, and you know, if you like to color code, you can definitely do that. So mine is Control Y, so let me show you what it looks like. Let's say I wanted to highlight these. So all I need to do is press Control Y and it will give me the highlighter. So you can actually customize this, not only the color, but the shape of the highlighting. So yeah, this is number one, really visual when you're trying to review your notes and draw out for your future self what you want to focus on. Highlighter is great. The second visual plugin is Emoji Toolbar. Yes, you can get a native emoji in Obsidian. They look something like this. And it has fuzzy search, so you can put in, you know, a very vague term and they will return all of the emojis for you. So if you use emojis, this is a must. So all you have to do is go to settings, community plugins, browse, find emoji toolbar. And once you've installed, enabled, go to hotkeys and just set up a shortcut for accessing the emoji toolbar. That's all you need to do. Now let's move on to the next visual plugin, which is Admonition, and it helps you make callouts. Now, just a quick update. Actually, Obsidian added callout natively into Obsidian, so you don't need Admonition to use callouts anymore. Let me show you what I mean by that. If you press Command P or Control P on the PC and you type in callouts, see there is insert callout and then there's Admonition insert callout. So the first callout is native to Obsidian. And it looks something like this. So it has a title and then you have the contents that you can edit. Now let me show you what the Admonition one looks like. Again, Command P or Control P, and you go to Admonition insert callout. Now here you have quite a different set of choices. Of course you have notes, see also abstract summary. So this is just customizing the callout itself in a pre-created way because they have icons on there as well. So for example, let's use hint. Then it's going to look green and has the little fire icon. And you can make it collapsible or not. Let's make it closed and insert to see. So see, now it looks very different. And you have to click in order to open it or close it, whereas this one is just open. So with Admonition, you have more customizability, but if you don't need that, you don't need the plugin. You can just insert Callout within Obsidian.
I also talk about two more visual plugins in this video, ExcaliDraw and Journey. Make sure you check them out in there.
There are a few very popular plugins that I have tried, but I do not use myself. And the most popular ones are Calendar, Kanban, and Advanced Tables. And the reason for that is based on why I'm using Obsidian in the first place. For me, this is a place to store notes, to review notes, to take input and turn them into output. It's a creative and thinking space. And when I tried to add things like Calendar, like Kanbans, it became a multi-use platform where I got easily distracted. The tasks every single day would get me looking at my Gmail and then getting lost in all of the tasks I have to do instead of focusing on ideas, trying to review them, trying to come up with them, and trying to connect them. So I want to say is just there are so many plugins out there. Use the ones that work for you. And if you haven't checked out the Essential Plugin video, check it out here, and I will see you in the next one.